Hey guys, so I was watching some Hell's Kitchen stuff, and I had this idea because this is totally something I would do because I'm a dick and because I don't care. So I would only, or anyone who has the same sense of humor I do, would only be able to do this if they were the best. Like you go in, you never have any issues. Chef, Ramsay never yells at you or anything like that. Because the idea I had would be fucking annoying to everyone else. But being the best chef, nothing's gonna happen to you because you're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. So, you know how Chef Ramsay likes to yell at people. And me, being the dick that I am, every time he starts yelling at people, I would just start doing like, just like pretend I'm crying. And not just once or twice, no, but every single time he starts yelling and just like pretend to go into this crying fit, it would annoy the fuck out of everyone. So he's like, get the fuck over here. And I just stand there like, or he fucking holds something up and he's like, who the fuck cooked this? And some other person's like, I did, chef. He's like, it's fucking cold. I just stand there. Every single time. Like I said, this can only work if you are the best. So if you go in there, you don't make any mistakes. Yeah, that's the only way it would work. Because like I said, yeah, it's gonna be annoying having someone constantly cry over everything. But you're the best. And that's what he's looking for, is the best. But then again, I mean, I guess the downfall would be, it's like, well, if you're crying, then you can't handle. It's like, well, obviously I can handle, the chef part of it, the cooking and everything, and obviously I'm able to keep up with the pressure. It's just I'm very sensitive. The fucking risotto, it's like it's fucking bland. And it's, I'm a dumbass. But yeah, it would only work if you were the best around and you could afford to do that kind of stupid shit because, yes, it would be annoying. But you wouldn't be voted off or anything because you're the best chef. So, but I'm sitting there watching, like, you have people walking around. Like, I just watched one and he tells this dude, I forgot his name, but it's like the dude's making spaghetti for no fucking reason. It wasn't even ordered. And he's like, why are you making spaghetti when no one's ordered it? It only takes 7 minutes to cook. And he's like, yeah, chef, sorry, chef. And then the guy does it again. It's like, why are you cooking spaghetti if no one's ordered it? Like, it takes 7 minutes. Why are you wasting your time over here with spaghetti? You don't make it in advance. You make it to order, like a fucking donkey. And that's when I would go, I love you and I miss you. No. Or the one girl, the same thing with pasta. It's like he says it's over. It was undercooked. So all she had to do was just put it back and it would have been fine. But no, instead she takes the entire thing and dumps it into the garbage. And then when he calls her out and he like looks inside the garbage and there's like fucking 5 pounds of pasta inside the garbage, all from this one girl. And she's like, and then when they do, they cut to her, like the little interview that they do when, talking about it. Throughout the episode, and same thing, she's like a fucking deer in headlights. It's like, you wasted 5 pounds of pasta for what? It's like, you need to fucking go. as an Italian, I am truly disappointed in you. I swear, I would fucking slap someone if they wasted that much pasta. Because, like, Ramsay just keeps, like, he has tongs and he keeps pulling pasta out of the garbage. He's like, who the fuck threw all this out? And then, like, he's putting it into a pan. It's just, like, piling up. It's, like, fucking 5-6 pounds of fucking pasta. And the girl's standing there, like... I'm like, fuck. Come here. Come here. Don't fucking waste pasta like that. Yes, it's cheap and easy to make, but it's fucking pasta. Come on. Pasta. I have to keep checking on my phone. I mean, I've managed to get my phone to the point where I get it to, you know, charge without really having to, you know, fight with it for 30 fucking minutes. But, it is at the end of my bed, as you can see. I would just buy a new one, but I can't afford it. So, you know, there's that. Also, if you guys... Oh! You guys remember these, or have these before? The Chico Sticks? What is it? They're, crunchy peanut butter rolled in toasted coconut. Simple ingredients. But, they come individually wrapped, and, that's what they look like. Come on. Focus. Focus! Focus! But, yeah, just, they're pretty good. I used to eat these when I was a kid, too. What's it say here? Ingredients: cane sugar, corn syrup, peanut butter. Contains fresh ground dry roasted peanuts. Mm-mm-mm. Salt: preserved with vitamin E to maintain freshness. Toasted coconut, turmeric color, vegetable juice color. Natural vanilla flavor and palm kernel oil. Atkinson Candy Company, Lufkin, Texas. It's from Lufkin, Texas. Chico Stick. The distinctive treat is made from a unique blend of toasted coconut and fresh-made peanut butter wrapped in a crunchy candy shell. From the first crumbly bite, you'll taste the peanut butter and coconut combining into one exciting flavor experience. Ooh. Chico Sticks are handmade with simple ingredients and nothing artificial. Atkinson Candy Co.'s skilled confectioners take great pride in making each Chico Stick with exacting care. We make all our candies to order, which ensures they reach you tasting fresh and delicious. The Atkinson family is proud to continue tradition of quality confections made right here in the U.S. since 1932. From our family to yours, enjoy. Eric Atkinson, present. Made in America. Serving size is 3 pieces. Yeah, if you're a fucking hobbit. Yeah, that's what I... Yeah, if you see those, pick them up. They're pretty good. I mean, it gets stuck in, like, your teeth and everything, but nowadays, what doesn't get stuck in your teeth? Yeah, if you see them, pick them up. They're pretty good. But yeah, Gordon Ramsay would find that so fucking annoying, but he would keep you around because you were the best. And, that's what he looks for, is the best. So you could do whatever you wanted. And I've said this before, especially when I watch it, when I see them wasting food. I've said this before because I used to work in places that waste food. I can't stand that shit. I cannot fucking stand that shit. And for people who are new, who have subscribed to me, who don't go back and watch my old videos and rather just watch my newer ones, who haven't heard my stories, I used to be a caterer at SeaWorld. I used to work at Ingles as a grocery store where they would throw stuff away. But I worked at Burger King. Burger King, like I've said, I mean, obviously I'm not going to deep story, but, you know, for people who have heard this 30 million times, but for new people, working at Burger King, we were able to take food home at the end of the night. So I was like able to take almost everything home because no one else wanted to carry it. So normally I was able to get a ride home with my friend if I just promised her to give her food. So like, I'm like, hey, yeah, I'm already at work. Think you can get me home? I'm like, I'll get you some food. And when I got her food, it was like a couple days worth of food. She's like, do they still have chicken left over? Because she liked the chicken sandwich, not those weird long ones, but like the chicken, the fried chicken looking ones. And I'm like, yeah, there's still plenty. They're like, she's like, yeah, can you make me a few sandwiches? I'm like, sure. We also had like four pans of like Whopper meat left, and so I'd make myself a burger that's like this fucking thick. I'd have like 3-4 patties on there, like pile it with fucking cheese, not cheese, but plenty of cheese to fit the, you know, the size of it. We would have like onion rings left over. I'd basically make a really fucking thick Southwest burger or whatever it was. Onion rings, barbecue sauce, mayo, bacon. And I'd go home like with those really big, you know, those big Burger King bags, the brown ones. I'd go home like 3-4 of those, and I'd have like patty meat for like 2 weeks. And you could use that, chop it up enough, you can make fucking tacos out of that shit. You put it in spaghetti, you can, you know, obviously have burgers with it. It was really good. And then they had like this thing, oh, we can't do it anymore, like take stuff home. At least that's what they said, but we still did. For some reason, we had to throw a certain amount away every night, which was really fucking stupid. But I still was able to take stuff home. Working in Ingles, same thing. I have to take the garbage out in the bakery, back in by the deli. And they were like, hey, John, we're about to throw out these cookies and donuts and whatever. It's like, did you want to take some home? So I'm going home with like fucking containers worth of shit from Ingles, like cookies and donuts. And then I go to the back and they're like, oh, there's fried chicken and, you know, mashed potatoes and all this stuff left over. Did you want to take it home? Because everyone knew my position, my situation, because I only worked like 2 days a week for only 30 minutes each. So they knew I wasn't able to pay for anything for myself. So since the managers were gone at night, they weren't there at the time I was there. Normally it wouldn't have been allowed, but since no one was there and no one was going to snitch on anyone, I was able to take shit home. So, and then at SeaWorld, since you cater to like some of the, like one of the biggest events was like 10,000 people. It's like 5,000 people the first time and 5,000 the second time or something like that. And it was like a buffet style. So we had to, like a never-ending line of food type thing. But when those were over, we had to throw the stuff away, but we ate as much of it as possible first, since, you know, didn't like wasting food. And I still don't. I fucking hate it. That's why if I go to a buffet or something like that, I'll take what I know I can eat, because if I'm not able to eat something, it pisses me off. Because I don't like wasting food at all. So even like basically if I'm eating something and it gets to the point where I feel like I'm about to throw up, I'll do everything I can to make more room. Like I'll sit there, try to burp, I'll go to the bathroom or something like that just to make more room. And if I'm not able to finish what's on my plate, it pisses me off, because I'm like, this is wasting it. So I don't know if anyone else is like that full. I don't like wasting. I mean, everyone doesn't really like wasting it, but some people don't go to the extent of well, I'm going to do whatever I can to eat whatever's left on my plate. But yeah. Yeah. I actually kind of miss working at those places because that food was always fucking good. Like, seriously. But even with, you know, Burger King, you know, the food may not be super, but, you know, when you're making it yourself, because I was the one who made patties, or not made them, you just take the frozen patty, you put them in the little broiler thing, and just spits them out when it's done. But since it was me making the burgers myself, they were nicely made. They looked like they should in the commercials, because I took pride when I made my food. You know, because, you know, it's an art form, really. That's why it's called culinary arts. It is an art form. That's why they dress things up and make it look nice. It's appealing to the eye. It's aesthetically pleasing, even though you know that you're going to eat it. It's all going to look the same when it comes out. It's aesthetically pleasing. And so when I made mine, unlike them, where that, you know, you go to like Burger King or McDonald's and like the fucking patty's hanging off and everything's just all over. Mine was nice and uniform. It was nice and neat. And it was nice. You know, so if they had made the burger that I did, it'd be fucking squished and like fucking shit all over the place. But mine was a nice, thick burger, nicely wrapped, nice and tight to let it hold its shape. Yeah. I took a lot of pride when I made my own food, and that's what made it more appetizing, because I made it. I got everything exactly the way you like it, so I put as much mayo as I wanted on, as much bacon, and considering it was the end of the night, all that shit had to be replaced in the morning anyway. So. But, yeah, I just hated wasting food. I still do, obviously. Which, I want to go to CC's. Or pizza. I mean, I've gone to CC's more than enough, but Pizza Hut's like one of those ones where they don't have the buffet all day. It's from like, what time does it start? Like 11 to 3 or 11 to 2? Hang on. So I checked, it said apparently it's from the time it opens to about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So, I mean, I guess that makes sense. It's lunch buffet, and it usually the store I think opens like 10-11 o'clock, so I guess that makes sense. We actually have two Pizza Huts here in town. There's one on 52 and then one on 2427. I've eaten at both of them. The one on 2427 seems to have the better selection, even though they should all have the same thing, but it's like the room, and then it's like right dab in the middle of the room, so you're getting it everyone's way. The other one is a lot better because it's against the wall, so you're not getting in anyone's way. You just go up there and, you know, there's no tables around, or, you know, so that one's the buffet setup is better, but the one on 2427 is more aesthetically pleasing, you know. A better looking atmosphere. The other one's like a more, it's smaller, and no one seems to really go to that one. It seems like the only people who are really there are the employees half the time. Me and my friend have gone there a few times, and yeah, whenever we go, there's just us and maybe like one other person. And then I went in there one day and someone recognized me from work, because when I worked at Burger King, I worked with one of their, actually, was it, it was, what's her name, Cheryl? It was one of the women I worked with, and she was weird. She was like fucking 37, 38 years old, but she looked like she was like 50 because of like the drugs she had done. She had like no fucking teeth. And, she used to say, "Oh my God," a lot. It was fucking annoying. And she was constantly going outside for a smoke break, and it's like, why is she even here? Like, why is she here? She's outside like 3-4 fucking times an hour taking a smoke break. No one needs a smoke break that much, especially when we're busy, you know? But I went in, I think it was one of her daughters, she recognized me. And I'm like, I didn't. Or did I? John, you're an ass. I know I'm an asshole. You asshole. Some of this stuff is just so out of the blue, and it flows into each other. You know, the whole, yeah, she recognized me, so, you know, I just, you know, it just, that just, but, yeah, we have two Pizza Huts, we had two, Waffle Houses, we have two McDonald's, we have, like, $3 Generals in town, two on the same road, there's two on, like, on 52, we have Dairy Queen. We have plenty of gas stations. Small town, plenty of gas stations. I mean, we pretty much have most of your typical fast food places. We have McDonald's, we have Burger King, we have Taco Bell, Zaxby's, Hardee's, or Carl's Jr., depending on where you're from. Chick-fil-A. We have a Dunkin' Donuts, we have Arby's, we have Pizza Hut, Little Caesars, Papa John's, I hate Papa John's though, Domino's, and it's strange because this town really didn't used to have a lot in it. They've been trying to make the town more like a mini Charlotte or mini Concord, you know, like a bigger, town. I mean, Concord's not really a town. We're not a city. Charlotte's a city. You know, you consider cities skyscrapers and stuff like that. So Charlotte's the city. Concord's just a big town, which there's a lot to do there. You have the mall there, which people love to go to. They added an aquarium there, which is pretty cool. But they also have like this little, like, amusement park type thing outside. And but yeah, they've been we also have what is it, Applebee's. We just got a Biscuitville. I don't know what they sell there, but it's a sit-down restaurant, so you could probably guess they have like chicken fried steak, a lot of southern home cooking stuff, probably a lot of biscuits, you know. Kind of like Chick-fil-A. I have no idea what they sell there. What did I say? Zaxby's? I think I said Zaxby's. Got Chinese Kitchen. We had a Chinese buffet, but it got shut down for reasons. We have a Sweet Frog, which is pretty good. Anyone who doesn't know, Sweet Frog is like this frozen yogurt kind of place. You go in, they have, you know, the flavors lined up, and you can kind of choose what you want, and you can put toppings, do it all yourself, but they kind of do it by weight, so however big it is, when you get it, that's how much. So like I said, if you take like a big old, the biggest cup, biggest bowl or whatever, and just, it's gonna be like fucking $20. So yeah, I've talked about when I did that with a salad, don't do that. Make sure it's, you know, a certain price before you start piling it high with shit, because then you're going to be paying $30 for a fucking ice cream. What was it? Palermo's? We have a lot of stuff. Was it Palermo's over there by PetSmart? Also we have Cookout, which is it's pretty good. I mean, Cookout's really good because they have seasonal milkshakes. We have Sonic, but Cookout, like the seasonal milkshakes, like now they'll have like a pumpkin pie one, even though Dairy Queen has it over there. But they also have an eggnog milkshake, which I drank my eggnog already, but I bought it last night, and I drank it all last night. John, you're a fucking pig. No, I just like eggnog. But they'll have seasonal, like, in the summertime, they'll have it, like, fresh berries or watermelon shakes. It's really good. They're kind of small, though. Compared to, say, Sonic, where you can get this big fucking honker of a shake. I remember trying the chocolate bacon shake when it came out. It was interesting. It was great, but I ordered the biggest one. I didn't think it would be as, greasy as it was. But that was a lot of bacon. It was a lot of bacon, tell you that. And even though that was, like, the only thing I'd eaten that, or, you know, had that day, I was like, oh, God. There was a lot of bacon in that. But we also have Steak and Shake, which is really good, but that's not in town. That's I think the closest Steak and Shake is Concord or Locust. Is it Locust? No. No, I think Locust has Andes. Andes is really cool. It's kind of like Steak and Shake in the sense that they've got that 50s aesthetic, you know, the checkered floors and, you know, like pictures of Marilyn Monroe and James Dean and stuff like that. You got the jukebox. So same aesthetic for the most part. Kind of like a Hard Rock Cafe, except not Hard Rock or Cafe. But they had this cool challenge. It was like a burger that was like maybe this tall. I think it was like 8 patties or something. It was like a challenge. And I say challenge because for me, that's child's play. My friend was like, you could probably do that. I'm like, yeah, I know I could do that. But it's like, it doesn't say what the prize is. It just said to, you know, that it was there. It didn't say, oh yeah, eat all these patties and you get those. So, for anyone who doesn't know, I've eaten a 6-pound burrito before, a cookie about half the size of your head, and about 3 sodas, like 3 large gulp-sized sodas. And then I walked out hungry. So, I have a very large, insatiable appetite that I don't know how to satiate. I've been trying to satiate it for a long time. I'm surprised I don't look like Fat Bastard at this point. Fucking 3,000 pounds. Satiated. No, I mean, I don't think I can eat that much anymore. I mean, I try to eat as little as possible now. Considering I don't have much money for food anyway, so I try not to eat as much. But I do want a burger though. Maybe tomorrow. Maybe I'll go to the pizzeria tomorrow. Cause we've got the pizzeria right down there. I was gonna go out tonight and see maybe if they had the lights on. They've got the lights out for Christmas. Down the street and across to, you know, by the posts and all that, but they haven't turned it on. They also started building that tree, which is really stupid. They have a perfectly good tree that they've been decorating. But now instead of just around the tree, now they just build a fake one, which is stupid. Killing me, Smalls. But I might go out tomorrow for a burger. That sounds really good. A mouthful of meat. If people don't realize that I don't take myself too seriously by now, where have you guys been? I don't take myself seriously, or really anything seriously at all. I mean, unless it's work. Because, you know, when you're working with heavy machinery, you kind of need to take it seriously because that shit can kill you. But myself, when I'm recording and all that, life's too short to take things seriously. You know? If you want to be some fucking idiot lefty who fucking gets offended over literally everything, like everything is racist now, if that's how you want to live your life, then you're not living your life. You're being offended over everything and restricting yourself because, I don't want to offend anyone. So, that's why I don't take anything too seriously. Life is just too short. Especially mine, considering I don't want to live past the age of 40. So I've only got, what, a couple years left. I'm kidding. I've only got about 8 years left to live. Try to do as much as possible in 8 years. John, you won't die. Yes, I will. I guarantee you I will be dead before or by 40. And not of my own doing. That's just my life. That's just how my life works. Although, because I want to die, my luck is that I live extremely long. Like, I'm going to be one of those people who live, like, to, like, fucking 150, but I'm going to be in pain and absolutely miserable the entire fucking time. So, because that's my luck. I want to die, but nope, nope. You're going to live as long as possible, and by then it's going to be like, oh yeah, we're going to use this on you. It's going to make sure you never die. Oh boy, the elixir of life. But, anyways, I've rambled on far too long. My choice is made. Oh, John. You funny fucker. Anyways. Yeah, you guys know the drill. I'll see you guys later.